Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Palpable excitement, childlike curiosity, and a tinge of cynicism. This is what marked the mood of passengers boarding the Tejas Express, touted to be India's first private train inaugurated on Friday. The Print too hopped onto the train on Sunday to gauge if all the hype was worth it or not. Almost immediately after boarding the train, several passengers began clicking photographs and video calling their families to show them around. The excitement was unmistakable. In fact, one passenger, P.N. Singh, a businessman from Varanasi, cancelled his pre-booked Indigo flight and opted for a Tejas instead, merely for the experience of it.
फ्लाइट से ही इंडिगो से ही जाना था वाराणसी के लिए बट मैंने टिकट कैंसिल करा के मैंने तेजस को लिया बड़ा नाम सुना था मैंने कि विश्व स्तरीय ट्रेन है तो मैं भी सोचा कि मैं भी इस ट्रेन का लुत्फ उठा लूँ इसकी वजह से मैं इसकी यात्रा कर रही
पर जैसे ये ट्रेन तो सिर्फ लखनऊ तक जाएगी फिर आप वहाँ से कैसे जाएंगे
मैं लखनऊ जाऊँगा लखनऊ के बाद मैं अपनी गाड़ी मंगा लूँगा मैं उस गाड़ी से जाऊँगा
तो आपका एक्स्ट्रा सफर हो जाएगा एक्स्ट्रा सफर हो जाएगा
कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं कम से कम देश को देखने के लिए थोड़ा एक्स्ट्रा सफर तो करना ही पड़ेगा
Tejas Express runs from New Delhi to Lucknow and its one standout feature is the staff who share a striking resemblance with an airline crew, both in attire as well as in manner. But that shouldn't come as a surprise as the Print learnt that most of them have been actually hired from air hostess training academies and the brief given to them was to serve like this is an airplane on tracks. Their badges read coach crew, evidently taking off from the term cabin crew, as they went around trying to sell products like Bluetooth speakers, headphones, chargers, and hand creams, much like the merchandise sold on flights. And while everyone was left mighty impressed with the politeness of the coach crew, many still said they would go back to the good old Shatabdi.
आई थी शताब्दी एक्सप्रेस से और वापस लौट रही हूँ तेजस से दोनों की ही फैसिलिटी मुझे बहुत अच्छी लगी दोनों में ज़्यादा डिफरेंस नहीं लगा बस यहाँ का स्टाफ तेजस का स्टाफ थोड़ा ज़्यादा पोलाइट लगा
Tejas was expected to cut the time taken to travel between Delhi and Lucknow to 6 hours 15 minutes as opposed to the 6 hours 40 minutes taken by the Swarna Shatabdi. But much to the disappointment of the passengers, Tejas ended up taking nearly the same time even though one Tejas ticket costs around 600 to 700 bucks more than a Shatabdi ticket. Now, although the physical infrastructure of the Tejas remains in the hands of the Indian Railways, the services provided, such as ticketing, catering, and housekeeping, are all contracted to private players. So, Tejas is being seen as a potential disruptor of the monopoly of the Indian Railways on trains in India.
अगर प्राइवेट में अगर इन्होंने किया तो इन्होंने भी ड्राइवर को हायर किया इन्होंने कंडक्टर को हायर किया इन्होंने भी अटेंडेंट को हायर किए हैं या उसके बाद फैसिलिटीज दे रहे हैं तो क्या दिक्कत है हम देश के ही नागरिक को तो नौकरी मिल रही
But the flip side of privatization is that all the concessions that passengers usually avail on trains are not applicable here. This means no subsidized fares for senior citizens, cancer patients, students or even the railway staff. Not everyone was happy about that.
लग रहा है ज़्यादा किराया लग रहा है और सीनियर सिटीजन को कोई लाभ इसका नहीं मिल रहा है जो कि आज के हिसाब से सीनियर सिटीजन को जब सरकार इतना महत्व दे रही है तो सीनियर सिटीजन को इसका लाभ मिलना चाहिए
The Tejas Express journey ended up being a bittersweet experience for many of its passengers. Despite impressive airline-like service, what many passengers were looking for was something more than mere optics. They were looking for a speedy train that would save their time and be worth the extra money. Sadly though, many of them were left disappointed. Reporting for The Print, this is Fatima Khan. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel for more such videos.